So today is the day that Fedora 19 is released, and yesterday I upgraded both my guest as well as my host systems, and that means that basically the game has changed. So what I'm going to do today, I guess, is I'm going to just see what's broken, make an inventory of what's broken, and then I guess work toward fixing the issue so that the policy that was designed for Fedora 18 works on Fedora 19. Now, I already taken a look at Fedora 19, and yeah, that's pretty much stuff has changed, so it's really going to require a lot of work just to make it work. But yeah, that's just something we'll have to deal with. At least the upgrade went pretty well. So without further ado, SSH, Dominic, adds SSH netkb info. And then cd my login user, and lslz home my login user, now that's weird, oh yeah, of course I need to be root then. Yeah, there were the upgrades were pretty painful. Yeah, well, not generally, but with regard to SE Linux, because, well, as you might have noticed, my systems are so loaded with modifications to the policy that when I basically upgraded to the Fedora 19 policy, there was just so many conflicts that I had to take care of. It was just not funny. So yeah, it may well be that some policy has broken. Now, probably not with regard to my login user. I'm pretty that's broken as well, but that's broken for a different reason. But there are other things that are broken. For example, git admin can probably no longer administrate git repositories because the git system contents type attribute was removed or renamed, I'm not sure yet, in Fedora 19. So I just commented it out to get rid of the conflict or get rid of the known type attribute, just to get it to work, but that leaves the policy kind of broken. And the same goes with other stuff though. There were other issues as well, and yeah, that happens. At least it works, kind of. And that's all Z. Oh, my login user. It's still very early, so I'm very slow. See, there's a directory there, so I need to clear my login user shell, and temp is clean because I rebooted a couple times since then, so that's pretty clean. Let's do an lsl user again. So yeah, now we're pretty clean. So basically what we're going to do right now is we are going to se module db. And right after that, we're going to 740 and just log in and just see what's going on. And then just basically start at the beginning, I guess. 740. Okay, let's just go to our system here. I need to log out of this one here though. So let's just log out. This is my main login account, which is unconfined. That works fine. So let's do an out search. ABCTS. And we're at 8 o'clock, 8:30. And we're clean. So we're in permissive mode. Let's do a PS AUX. Grab 10, 12. That's weird. Get a new user ID? Are you kidding me? Oh, it's just not showing. Just a new way in showing the user. Now let's have a look, see what we got. We have to go start with the top. GNOME keyring daemon, GNOME session, dbus launch is fine. Dbus is fine. DVFS is fine. DVS Fusi is fine. Atsby is fine. Dbus is fine. I guess. Atsby 2 is fine. VD Agent is fine. GZD is fine. Pulse Audio is fine. Dconf is fine. Disk, the photo, AFC, the shell, printer, calendar daemon, evolution, source registry, mission control, online accounts, data dubmon, SE applet, tracker store, network manager applet, track minor FS, Evo alarm notify, DNS sec monitor, abort applet, Evo cal factory, tconf, metadata, and here we have something we need to do. So here we have the libexec gnome control center data provider, which is a dbus daemon, because it actually runs in the dbus domain right now. So that's basically the first thing we just need to take care of. So that's basically nano my login user FC. It doesn't actually look too bad. I was expecting much more issues. but doesn't look too bad at all. And then just copy this over. GCC search P, what a name, but GNOME Control Center Search Provider. Copy that. And then go to the type enforcement file and go all the way below. Paste that in, and then I'll have a look at something that gets started by the session bus and copy that over and find something. Here we have the hot plug sniff. So yeah, just do the same thing. It may be a different version of the distro, but it's still the same game. It looks like it might be a hot day today. The sun is shining already early in the morning. And the fact that I'm up this early means that it's usually a sign that it's gonna be a hot day. So I can't look at the ABC denials right now. That's just not a good idea because we have stuff running in the wrong domain. So we just need to take care of that first and then just start all over again. Could have been worse though. So yeah, this should take care of it. Let's make a user share as a limit deval. Make file my login user pp, and it builds se module my login user pp. And that's an I for install or insert. Then we need to, after that, we need to basically restore the context of this one here. But if that's all for now, then that's not that much. But there are other issues. We have, for example, GNOME Terminal, so that's pretty quick. GNOME Terminal has been redone, and actually many of these programs have been have had changes. Also noticed that I also noticed that Nautilus had minor changes. Okay. What we need to do now is basically see if we need to kill. Yeah, Pulse Audio is still fucked up. Nice, or at least nice. Seems to have actually deleted that file, or just maybe it's just not. Maybe it moved somewhere else. Seems to be gone. Oh, that's nice. That Pulse Audio doesn't leave any bullshit around. And what about Def Shem? Well, here it does leave stuff around. Here it does. Okay, dokie. So let's just have a look at a recent so that we clean. We're now at 34. So let's try 33. Clean. So we clean at 33. We're still in permissive mode, but we took care of. Let's just do a less, I guess, just to have a look at and see what's going on. Take a while. Yeah, see, there's still we still have a lot of stuff to do. Look, a lot of stuff has changed, as you can see. A lot has changed. A lot has changed, but first let's have a look at the stuff that's gets executed. Grab, execute, no, trans. So we have a couple of things here where. GNOME session runs GNOME settings daemon locale exec. Then we have dbus running GNOME documents, actually running GNOME documents. Then we have dbus actually running the JavaScript console, and we have dbus actually running Nautilus exec. Now these last two are reasonably simple, since we just basically actually the last one is simple because that's just basically a transition that we should add. But this one isn't so simple because this is actually documents running JavaScript console, so we need to actually take care of documents first before we can take care of that. So let's just do first things first. It's gonna take a little bit of time. Now this is actually a GNOME session domain, which is cd locale exec. So first take care of that. It's a GNOME session domain. Set the locale exec. What a name. And then go to the type enforcement file and just add it. Now this is a session and this is probably not a good idea. What was, oh yeah, Fino was a GNOME session, so we can basically take it from there. This is Fino password, we need another, this gedit, Fino do shell. And some of these, yeah, here it is. Fino do is actually, so we can take that. Of course, there are some differences though. For example, it doesn't run the help as far as I know. So the G settings daemon locale exec is a session daemon. And we just need to go through this. There is a lot of breakage. But it was to be expected. That's what's happening with the policy, that, well, stuff changes in the system, but you can't really change the policy with it with regards to removing stuff. Sure, you can just keep adding and adding, but you can't actually identify, oh, this feature has been removed, at least that's very hard, so I can remove the policy that is related to that. So what you get is that eventually the policy gets inflated more and more and more and more. So every once in a while, it's a good idea to just basically review it thoroughly. So this is G settings D, as far as I can tell. So basically, I'll copy this over. And then type this should be locale exec. What's going on? We declared the domain type. All right. This should take care of that. My beard starts growing again. Well, it's always growing. Restore con V. Alright, now let's take care of GNOME documents, which is actually run by Debus. This is Debus daemon. And then documents runs console, but that's that. Those two latest are the easy ones, or the easy ones are the quick ones. So I'll just add it below. G-docs. Dogs. And so this is again a Debus daemon domain, so we can basically just copy this over this stuff and just replace it. And then basically we can also go ahead and I'll just do first things first though. But so far, GNOME 3.8 looks pretty neat with regard to, at least with regard to, it's not freezing like 3.6 used to do. At least not so far, because, well, it's just been a single day that I'm running this. Alright. Yeah, alright. So let's just go ahead and take care of that. So and take a note of this, these two, before they move off the screen. Actually, they won't. So, gdocs runs console, and Dibas runs Nautilus. So, Dedox runs console. I think that's actually just changed, so that's no longer the doc search provider, but so we might actually be able to remove the doc search provider bit. Well, I'm not going to do it, but just to make a point that stuff changes due to in the versions, and it may well be that that the GNOME doc search provider no longer needs to run this, and instead docs runs it. May well be. So in that, if that's the case, then if this policy was only used in Fedora 19, then it would be a bit too coarse, because yeah, you would allow something that you don't actually need. But then again, on the other hand, if you want this policy to actually work on Fedora 18 as well, then yeah, you're going to want that. So now it's Nautilus actually getting run by Davis. Oh, not. Not that one. This one runs Nautilus. So Dibas. Nautilus. But that means that we probably need to, oh, actually you can. Move that here, it's a bit messy. What's you, man? Runs Nautilus. And then we're basically going to have to declare it here, because this is basically the top attribute. Runs. And then attribute runs out. Oh, without the command, of course. So you can remove it here because this is too low. So now we take care of all of this shit. And then it's the same thing all over again. Kill all, yeah, you know the dance. It's the same. the nice thing is the temp is pretty clean as far as I can see. Yeah, that still looks pretty clean as well. Been a while since I last ran this one here. 5-1 might not be clean. No, it's not clean. But 5-2 might be actually. I think I'm going to open up the window. What a mess. So it turns out that some stuff is actually also mislabeled. But we're going to figure it out. We're going to clean it up. For sure. Hold on a second. It's mighty hot. Oh, I'll get my coffee. Five, three, I was meaning to say. Are we clean? Yeah. We're clean at 5-3. So let's log in. And now let's see if our transitions are sorted. Going to be messy, obviously. Nah, it's still running some binary. Crazy. That's just crazy. Really some complex stuff going on here. Here, nah, sys provider is just checking for exact. Session is actually also checking XP for exact. Man, session. Now we have a leak. I think yeah, that's probably a leak. That XDM stuff it seems to be leaking a Unix stream socket file script to IM setting whatever. Anyways, you can look at it until you weigh in an ounce, but doesn't change the thing. You need to work. So first things first, execute no trans. And then grab, of course. You can look at it until you weigh an ounce. Christ. So we have still a lot of shit going on. Takes patience. Now we are at a point again where you get flooded but with problems, consciously you start to panic, and but you really have to take care, take easy, and just do it step by step. So this D-Settings is a user application, but we still need to take care of it. And it's getting run by Locale, I guess. Yeah, I guess. So, a nasty one again. A nasty one again. So let's just take this stuff here and then change that. Now, let's just move this already to the other side, because we know, let's just do that first. That's where it's belong, where it belongs. And then just edit this one here. And the same, let's just start with these first. Just change this. I can actually just take this part here. Okay, taken care of. Let's take care of this first. And then take care of these, which these are just transition issues. Oh, actually not. These two are transition issues. But we can take care of these two first. So locale execute gsetd and locale executes gsd printer. So it's gsetd locale exec t and then my login user, of course. So actually what's happening here is they did a they basically put in a new app in between session and settings daemon. So if this policy would only be for Fedora 19, then we could probably remove the session from this bit here, since that probably no longer applies. I'm not sure, of course, that's just assumption and speculation, but yeah, it may be the case. But since this policy should also be backwards compatible, we're just expanding the policy, we're just adding policy instead of actually changing policy. Okay, so that's one, and then what was the other one? Oh yeah, GSD printer. GSD print. And it's probably exactly the same issue here. Instead of GSD, it gets runs by GSD locale exec. It's probably exactly the same issue. They basically just added a new program in between session and settings. So all in all, quite a bit of changes, and this is just only on the surface. Doesn't actually tell me anything about the other programs. This is just about booting it. Oh yeah, now we need to take care of this one here, which is actually run by dbus. GD, I'm not sure what that means. What the name is all about. Quite a mess, but it's a dbus app. So how am I going to call this one? Another miner, as if we don't have enough miners already. Hmm. It's not quite a good name, but it's the best I can do. Okay, so it's a Debus daemon, so we can basically borrow that from docs, or yeah, from docs. So as you might notice, we're just first taking care of everything that's getting executed. Make sure domain transitions happen properly before we even look at anything else. But we do take special care into making sure that we actually know what is executed. We don't just look at the context involved, we also look at the commands involved. Make sure that the commands actually run in the expected domains before we actually allow something. All right, so that should take care of it, if it builds, at least. Oh yeah, I should make sure that this one is labeled. Restore confine. Yep. Okay. Log off. Once again. And then kill all you my login user and clear my login user shell, and it's all the temp still clean, it's deleting its stuff properly. I'll search MAVCTS 911 audit to allow less. Probably not clean. No, still those where Pulse Audio basically deletes its Pulse Audio file probably, and Pulse Audio sock. This is clean. Login. So we log on, log in. And take care of any execution. Yeah, we're still execution. Oh my god, what a lot of execution is going on. And we have this XDM leaked file descriptor. It seems to be a leak. But anyways, we still have execute no trance. It's really nasty. Execute no trance. It's really nasty. Here we have the damn fucked up. Another miner. As if we don't have enough miners already. But anyways, IM settings is running D settings. Let's take care of that first. First things first. Concentrating, don't mess up. But I'm going to change the name of the tracker. But because turns out we have something named pretty similar. But it's, yeah, it's pretty, a lot of stuff new. So let's just add this one in here and then add it. It's the deepest. Oopsie. Quite messy. So there we go. G data. G data. G data. Okay. And then just copy this over. And didn't just change the name. Hopefully at some point we're done with this, because it kind of gives me a weird feeling that if every point release adds so much apps, then it almost seems like a never-ending story. But I guess at some point you should be able to say that it's mature, and then when it's mature, that's probably going to be a num 4.0, and then we can start all over again. So it's really, really a process. It's really, you're really never done, and that's what kind of sucks, especially in the user space, because it just involves a lot of work, and it's like you don't get to enjoy your work, the fruits of your work, because you're constantly busy working. But I guess that's what policy writers implement, people implement policy do. They implement policy. I guess. So that seems suffice, and let's just don't need to restore this one again. Restore V. And it sets, and then also this one here. It's just another miner. This system mines a lot. But that's no problem in theory. Oh yeah, yeah, so now we basically need to log off again. I think they fixed that bug where you can only log in 5 times. And then that XDM crashes, I think so. Not sure, we'll see. I don't think I logged off 5 times yet, or maybe I have, but let's do the kill all. Let's do the clear all. And let's do the out to allow the out search. Wait till we clean. We're at 21. Not clean yet, so we need to wait for 22. And then all over again until we get rid of all the executes. Got rid of all the executes. It's a long road, indeed. We're clean. Let's log on, log in. So far it seems Dbus isn't actually running anything, so that's good. And this is a check for execute, so we don't need to bother about that. That's It's just checking execute, I guess. Well, here we have, oh, it's executing actually a temporary file, which is generic. And here we have something user temp. That doesn't make sense at all. Let's just grab for execute neutrons. None. So I think it's probably best that I take a break now. Probably the best, because now it's just well, it's not just but we took at least care of the initial domain transition, so in that sense probably good idea to at least take a short break now so that we can get ourselves a soda pop and a runt before we move on. Some stuff going on here, a lot of stuff actually going on. Here, this is weird. Oh, this is probably in a run user though. This is probably in run user. That's the only explanation I can give. And G session is executing or checking for exec. But yeah, there's a leak there. Or at least leak, yeah, I suspect it's a leak. Because every damn thing is trying to read write. And look at what's going on here. And this Binti needs to be taken care of as well. So let's just grab Binti. Although it's just checking for exec at this point, at some point. Yeah, so we need to also take care of this. Just so that we don't have to allow it to check exec on bin. So how do we do that? Well, we do it the same way as we did it before. We just don't add a transition. So we can basically take an example here. One example would be any of those Node, for example, Node.cs. Probably it. So if you do Node.cs, yeah, good example. It's also not getting executed currently yet, but we actually do that so that we can allow it to check exec. What else? Chainsaw. Use a bin chainsaw. So it really seems like we're just starting at zero again. That's the feeling you get, because we're going doing that same stuff again that we did when we started this. Basically make an inventory and then make sure nothing runs bin. Do the domain transitions first. So yeah, from that perspective, it seems like we're just starting all over again. That's not quite the case. And we do have now the experience that we had before, so we know where we're going. It's not like we're walking in uncharted territory. But on the other hand, we also know that it's basically a never-ending story. Let's probably use a bin. Evolution, it's actually bin T. Oh, that's probably fine. We'll see. But anyways, after I did this, I'm really gonna take a break. Because, well, this can go on for ages and ages. And these are like mandatory things that we need to focus on first. GNOME Control Center. GC center. That's what I call it, because if I call it GCC, then it's just not GCC. Probably hitting 10,000 lines or something now. By now. I wouldn't be surprised. And then we have known boxes. Then we need to basically restore all these models. So yeah, we have another set of things that we probably need to focus on, because shell doesn't execute that for its help. Or a checks execute for its help. It probably does so for a reason. Well, actually not quite. It just needs it, but doesn't actually mean that it actually needs to be able to run it, because, for example, GNOME boxes, it doesn't actually need to run that. It's probably something that I will not focus on enabling GNOME boxes. Although I could take care of that in a nice way later on, maybe. Maybe, maybe not. Probably not. There's too much work to be done anyways. They're already working on GNOME 3.10. Now make this and then restore the context. And then I'm just gonna clean up, and from that point, failed. Damn it. God damn it. There's always some shit. Been doing wrong. Christ. Well, at least they're still in the screen. Yeah, I need to make sure that I don't forget to restore on these. So I just want them on the screen so that I have a view. All reset. All right. Log off, clean up, and take a break. You kidding me? Yep, it's still not fixed. It's still not fixed. It's still not fixed. Nasty. Oh. Okay. Kill all. You, my login user. Then clear my login user shell lsalzdemp clean. I guess that's about it for now. Yeah, that's about it for now. So I'm just going to take a break. At least we took care of the initial file domain transitions, and we also took care of creating type private types for stuff that some GNOME components check exec of, so they probably decide, okay, we want to make sure that that's there, or we want to use something of it. So we made sure that that's possible, and then now basically we need to clean up a lot of a really lot of stuff. So that's for the next phase.